Hello students, welcome to Smart Engineering Tutorials. Today we are going to see another topic of Unit 3 of Communication System in IP University. Coding is used to improve the efficiency of a communication system. It maps a given set of messages from a source, say M1, M2 up to MN, into a new set of encoded messages, C1, C2 up to CN. Now this transformation is used to give one code word to each message of a source. And so we say that it is one-to-one mapping. One message will be given a one code word, and this code word cannot be given to any other message. This is called source coding. The code words can be of different lengths. Efforts are made to get minimum average length of the code in order to get increased transmission efficiency. In source encoding, the redundant information present in a message is removed, and this is done in the source encoder part of the circuit. We'll see in the diagram in the next slide. Source coding schemes, which we have to study in BTech course here, are of two types: Shannon-Fano coding and Huffman coding, which will be covered in other sessions. Other than source coding, there is also channel coding. In source coding, the redundant information is removed, while in channel coding, a controlled form of redundancy is added, and this is used to make codes or prepare codes for special purpose, like providing security or having minimum probability of error, etc., depending upon some application this channel coding is used. In this, the same thing which I told, in this redundancy is added in a controlled manner to achieve a special purpose. This is the diagram in which source encoding is used in a communication system. Here we have a source. It generates the messages. These messages are then converted into or mapped into a code in the encoder. So this is the source encoder. And after that, this coded message is sent over the channel, and then it is decoded to get back the message, and then it is sent to the receiver. Means here the coded version is decoded, and then the original message is recovered in the receiver part of the system. The terms which are used in coding should be known. They are letter, symbol, or character. This word represents the individual member of the alphabet set from which the individual members are used to make messages. Message or word, this message or word is made up of by combining the letters, symbols, or the characters. So we can say that it is a finite sequence of letters or symbols or characters in a message. Length of the word, it represents the number of letters present in a message. Now, coding efficiency, eta, it represents how efficient a code is. So we will derive the expression for eta. Let capital M be the number of symbols which are used and are present in an encoding alphabet. Let's say there are capital N messages, M1, M2 up to MN. And let N suffix I be the number of symbols present in the ith message. So the average length of the message, or the average length per code word, is obtained by the following expression. And as in the previous session, we had calculated the formula for entropy, and there Entropy represents the average information per individual message, and it was found by summation of all the messages and summation of the product of the probability of the message, which is the information in one message, multiplied by the probability of the occurrence of the message. There the derivation was used and based on those lines, this L bar, which is the average length of the code word, can be also written similarly. Summation, let's say there are n messages, so ni is represents the number of symbols or letters in one code word, and pni is the probability of the message, and the product of each terms of every individual message are added to get the L bar, that is the average length of the code word. Now, L bar, we have got the formula, and its unit is letters per message. For efficient transmission, this L bar, that is the length, average length of the code, should be minimum, so that in a given time interval, many code words can be transmitted. So the coding efficiency eta can be calculated by L bar minimum, that is the minimum value of L bar, divided by L bar. So what is the value of this L bar minimum? Let's say HX represents the entropy of the source and its unit is bits per message. Let log M, capital M represents the number of symbols, be the maximum average information associated with each letter, that is the letters are used to form the message. So the basic are the letters which are used to form a full message. So let log M be the maximum average information in each letter, and it is in bits per letter. If we find out the ratio HX upon log M, it will have a unit. HX has bits per message and log M has bits per letter. So when we cancel out the terms, we get letters per message. Here, the ratio in the denominator, we have log M, which represents maximum average information. So if the denominator is maximum, this whole quantity becomes minimum. So this ratio gives us the minimum number of letters per message. So we can say that L bar minimum is HX upon log M. So eta formula we get, or the efficiency formula we get, L bar minimum upon L bar, and in place of L bar minimum we put the value HX, that is the entropy, divided by L bar into log M. This is efficiency, and if multiplied by 100, it will give us the percentage efficiency. Redundancy is found by the formula 1 minus eta. Eta will be the numerical value, not in percentage form. So we can find this redundancy from here. Now, since in this formula we have the L bar in the denominator, so in order to have maximum efficiency, it is clear that denominator should be least value. So we have that to have maximum efficiency eta, L bar should be minimum. Now, there is a source coding theorem, or we can say it as Shannon's first theorem. It says that whatever we have discussed, it is in the form of a definition form or a statement form. Given a discrete memoryless source of entropy HX, we say discrete because it gives at some instance of time the outputs, and memoryless because its output does not depend upon the previous outputs. So for a given discrete memoryless source of entropy HX, the average code word length L bar for any distortionless source encoding is bounded as L bar greater than or equal to HX. That is, the minimum value of L bar cannot be less than the entropy HX. So entropy HX puts a fundamental limit on the average number of bits that can be given to every source symbol. So in the next session, we will discuss further, and subscribe to the channel for further notifications. Thank you.